great pleasure to be sitting here today with everybody from FICCI, analyzing what I think has been announced as a once-in-a-100-year budget, but truly has been a very powerful balancing act and set India on a positive growth path. I want to begin by saying thank you, dear FM, because many aspects of things that we've been speaking about for the last year or 2 years have really come to fruition in today's budget, whether it was the development financial institutions, the need for patient capital to come into the country, the need to enhance capital expenditure and not worry about the fiscal deficit, but to be able to explain the fiscal deficit in a manner which would not affect India's ratings. And therefore, the very creative aspect of the glide path, very, very well handled. But mostly, I must say thank you for the much needed and long-awaited focus on healthcare. I think clearly, the total budget outlay for healthcare at 2.23 lakh crores is about 137% increase from last year. And it is this kind of jump that we really needed. Government spending is now 1.9% of GDP, which is critical. In combination with out-of-pocket and corporate spending, Indian healthcare sector is now inching towards a allocation of close to 5%, and this is, I think, quite significant. Moving on, I think the announcements on the Atmanirbhar Swasth Bharat, on the Jal Mission, on the intent to improve primary, secondary and tertiary, the focus on district as well as on urban primary healthcare centers, the much needed look at a CDC-type disease surveillance are all very, very positive responses to the entire journey that India and I think the world has been through in terms of COVID. And I think it sets us very clearly on the path of showing once again that India can handle good quality healthcare. It's a recognition of the capability of the public and the private. It's an enhancement of what is possible in the pharmaceutical industry, which was already the path had been laid and further enhanced with the PLI. And now I think it really pushes us towards universal health coverage and can lay a platform for India leading the world. I will conclude really by saying that we have the potential in healthcare to do for the country what the IT sector did for the country in the last decade can happen through healthcare in this decade. And this is one more significant step towards achieving that. So kudos to our finance minister and to the prime minister and the government, because this is truly a comprehensive, holistic response across sectors and a very special focus on healthcare.